hearing to order and ask if there is anyone who would like to speak to the issue of the town accepting $29,829.42 in additional highway block grant funds. If there's anyone who would like to speak to that. Charlie and Nancy, you seem to be our only two folks here at Salome.
I think it's a really good idea that you accept it, first of all. I still question as to whether it can be used for equipment, so.
I do too, and we've gotten additional guidance that also suggests that that would be problematic.
Okay.
Anybody else would like to speak to this?
Just repeat the same thing.
Yeah. Salome, anything to say?
Yeah, no, I do wish you could get that Volvo out of here. I think it's a money pit.
Okay, so, well, I'm going to hold this open just for, you know, we'll just sit quietly for a couple of minutes just to see if anybody else shows up. I did get an email from, I could read that, from a Kelwyn Drive. I don't know if it was the entire board or just me. Did you get that?
Yes, I did get it.
Okay, what is her name so I can find it? Bonnie Brown, okay. I'm a resident of Kelman Drive, and unfortunately I'm not able to make the meeting tonight due to another meeting. This is Claudia Brown on Kelman Drive, sorry. I'm writing to request you consider Kelman Drive when deciding where to spend the additional $30 million in highway funds. And I'll speak to that in a minute. The additional $30 million in highway funds have problems we've received from the state. Our road has many potholes, bumps, and rocks that are not only rough on our cars, but dangerous for our kids. My daughter had to get stitches because she hit a pothole while riding a scooter around the block. We've lived on Kelvin Drive for 11 years. The road is just getting worse every year. Please, please, please consider fixing Kelvin Drive. That was from Claudia Brown. And let me just say one thing about $30 million. If we had an additional $30 million from the state of New Hampshire, we wouldn't have a problem in the world.
Everything would be fixed.
Everything would be fixed. So $30 million is the amount of money that the state gave away to all of the municipalities in the state of New Hampshire. And our portion of that $30 million is $49,829.42. So we don't have $30 million. If we did, we would certainly fix Kelvin Drive. I think it was the public notice that.
Did you email her back?
I did. I forgot to mention about the $30 million, I think. Maybe I did.
No, you know what it is.
Did I say it?
Okay. That was the total. Our portion was.
But you know, it goes to show that, you know, when you don't work in roads and bills, I mean, you have no idea how much things cost or what,
no.
You know? So, but boy, the $30 million that fixes about everything in this town, I think.
Do you
want to
know
how
much a new fire hydrant costs? Just a fire hydrant?
No.
$4,000. Just the fire hydrant.
We'd still be able to fix all the roads.
All the culverts.
All the culverts.
All the bridges.
Police station.
We might be able to do sidewalks.
In the village, yeah. We could do an awful lot.
Yeah, I could get a sidewalk for down Rollins.
Yes, that would be wonderful.
Or a bike.
All right, I'm going to put the public hearing in recess, and we'll just keep it open until 6:30. So we're now in recess. All right, it is now 6:30, and I will call to order the select board meeting of Monday, August 8th. Sorry, Sammy, did you have a question, comment that I missed?
Are you going to close the public hearing?
Oh, very good point. And I will also, now we've got both things going. So I'm going to recess the select board meeting. I'm going to now reopen the public hearing. Thank you for reminding me about that. Is there anyone who would like to speak to the town's acceptance of the $49,000 plus from the state of New Hampshire? Going once, going twice, going thrice. I will now close the public hearing. Thank you. Now I will come back to the select board and get us out of recession and into regular meeting. So first order of business are the board meetings of July 31st. Jody, anything?
So moved.
Okay, so by consensus they've been accepted. And we'll go right to department head. Jeff?
So tonight I got a couple purchase orders. 0976 to Allied Equipment, and these are for the cotton edges for $3,200. And it's the outfit, the GMC Top Kick. Front plow that hit the wing for that truck. The International, the wing, which is the truck I drive. And the F-350 plow. And that's for all the bolts and shoes that's required. And we should be good for the beginning of the season, hopefully for the year.
Move to accept purchase order 974 to Allied Equipment for cutting edges for International, the GMC Top Kick, and the F-550. For a total of $3,200.
I second. So Jeff, is this, Caroline sent us email kind of warning us about this.
Yeah.
Is this the sum total of the cutting edges?
That's it, yeah. Okay. So all the trucks would be ready to go in that line.
All right, so it is going to cause us to relook at the tree.
Yeah, I gave that back to
So until we get closer, until we figure out what.
Yeah, so I don't know if you got the email, but the line striping this year.
Oh, she did say something about that.
Yeah, the line striping for roads and park installs. It was like $4,000.
All right, what, do you mind if I bring that up?
Yeah,
so line striping has a budget of
$4,000,
and nothing's been spent, and so
don't do it this year, we have to do it next year.
All right, so you're saying that, that's a possibility?
Yeah, put it over on certain items.
Okay. All right, and the other one you said was?
Trees.
Right, nice, right.
I'd rather not give that up, but if we have to, we will.
So we are still waiting to see how the state, Eversource, what it clears up as a result of.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, you know, or rather than, we've got the PO, so we'll just put it on hold. Is that okay? And then we won't actually, you know, unless Jody wants to do it, we won't void it tonight. We just.
Just wait to see what Eversource does, because they're out trimming three-phase lines right now.
Okay. All right. Are there any other questions, comments on this? All those in favor say aye.
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 Another purchase order for Chadwick Bay Ross. 0975, and that's to have the AC fixed and other electrical components that are causing the AC not to work because they were shorting out, for the sum of $2,642.98.
Move to accept purchase order 975 to Chadwick Bay Ross to have work done on the Volvo backhoe, and this was the AC work.
Yeah, it had shorted out electrical wires, and it had switches that weren't working properly, and...
Well, let me second it, then we can keep going.
For a total of $2,642.98.
Okay, so I'll second that. So what is their degree of certainty that they fixed the problem? Not yours,
it's fixed. It's fixed for now.
So, and that's what you're saying too, it's fixed for now.
Yep.
Okay. So, Jody, just so you know, I mean, we have it right now, but then that pretty much shoots it. Is there other maintenance work that you're anticipating, like registrations or inspections or anything?
Registrations will be coming up for all the trucks. And I do have a couple of hydraulic lines to change on one of our trucks that are showing steel, and the small ticket items.
So Jeff, what would you think about if we just moved the $4,000 from line striping to the vehicle?
That's what I was intending on.
Okay. All right. So that gives us, you know, again, a little, just a little bit of breathing room.
And I'm pricing out spinner motor right now for one of the trucks. The spins product off the back. I think they were $5,200 approximately.
Okay, Jody, is there, do you have any other questions or comments on this?
No.
All right, then I will call a question. All those in favor say aye.
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 And the board mentioned last week, or the week before, to get a hold of a couple dealers on the equipment to possibly trade that Volvo in towards another machine. And to do comparable machines, these are both brand new machines. So
with
long as
comparable,
no tracks,
comparable functionality.
Right down, I mean, you know, it goes by weight usually when you're comparing a machine. Weight and dig in depth.
Yeah.
So John Deere came in at $72,440 for a new machine plus our machine, so it cost us $72,000. And Case came in at $49,50 for a brand new machine plus our machine. So here's all the paperwork on that. I'll let the
machine. Do you know how long the quotes are good for?
Usually 30 days.
30 days.
Usually.
All right, well, thank you.
Thank you.
So we'll probably wait till Mike gets back, but unless the guidance changes, I'm not sure that they're going to let us buy.
That's fine.
All right, anything else?
That's it for me.
Yeah, I'd just like your thoughts on the...
We actually have a non-public to do tonight.
Okay.
We'll go through.
Okay. So I'd like your thoughts on the culvert work.
They started Thursday of last week, putting all their signs up, bringing barricades in, brought the job trailer in. Thursday and Friday last week.
Where's the job trailer, by the way?
Down at Lower Mill, tucked over in the corner.
At Lower Mill?
Uh-huh.
Why?
Because there's no room to put it anyplace else.
I thought the Legion had said I'm confused. I thought Bear Bryant said no, and the Legion said
we
yes.
We could put the job trailer down there, which just is a little trailer they stuck off in the back. Like, you don't really know it's there.
So Brian is okay with that?
Brian, yeah, he seemed to be. He was there when we unloaded it.
Okay.
The laydown yard is all the excess material that they're hauling out when they're taking their cut for this culvert. They're stacking them over by the Legion, where they told us we could. So they haul loads of material over there because the road's so narrow.
Yeah.
They don't have no room to stockpile material. No room, really.
Yeah, so the office trailers in the Lower Mill,
okay.
And the material, all the stuff that they're using is in at the Legion.
Yep, by the Legion area that the Legion gave us.
Okay.
So they got an area grubbed out. They set their first piece of pipe today. We found the sewer line, which was one of the goals for today.
Yep, has John been there?
John Englund was there all day today to make sure everything was there.
Okay,
Boyle and Tanner stopped by for like an hour or two this morning, made sure everything was on the up and up.
Yep, that's good.
And
is there a USDA sign yet?
There is.
There is.
It's up.
On what side?
It's on the Prospect Street side.
Okay.
It's actually right by the job, right by the
yep,
culvert.
That's fine.
So.
And they can move it as they.
Yeah, it's on post. It's,
right.
It's,
all right.
They drove post in there.
So everything seems to be going fine, and the log work
yeah, everything's good.
Okay, thank you. Appreciate it.
Seems to be pretty good.
All right. Anything else? Did you say you wanted some?
I have a non-public, but do you have anything else for me?
Yep.
No.
Yeah.
Going to non-public for reading the personnel?
Yep.
I'll second that. Do a roll call, Jody?
Yes.
Suzanne, yes.
How are you?
Do you have the equipment stuff in this? So you have it, so you know what it is.
Yes, did Jody keep it?
I think she put it in.
Okay, thank you. Yep, appreciate it. This is for the equipment quotes? Just a folder of equipment.
Yeah, I put both of the equipment quotes in there just so you kind of know what it is. What is what?
the board is sorry to announce that Jeff has just submitted his resignation from his job as road agent. And he served us for a solid 5 years, six years?
Seven years
of good service. We appreciate it. We thank him. But at this time, I will ask for a motion to accept Jeff's resignation.
Motion to accept Jeff St. Jean's resignation, starting end date effective September 5th, 2017.
I will reluctantly second that. Any comments or questions or discussion?
No. Jeff, thank you so much for your service.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jeff.
And,
I will call the motion. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay.
Have a good night.
Thank you.
Good night, John.
You too. All right. Chief.
Whoa. Jump right in there. Sure, that's probably not the way you're
supposed to start. You sound like Don't do that to us.
I got equipment updates for you.
Okay.
Basically, is where I'm at for today. First thing that I have is on the engine, and it is moving along in its production without any issues. We sat down with the representative that was in here with us that time. We went over some minor changes, some stuff that we deletions and some additions and whatnot, just to kind of fine tune some things. And that requires a
change order
from you guys. That's all it is. And basically, with some of the changes that we made, we've actually got a credit of $278.
Excellent.
So there's nothing going over, and then there'll be some more. So, and the thing is, I need to get this signed so I can get it back to Jerry so I can get it squared away. So. And you know, again, it's just minor, you know, change some springs for this compartment, change out something here and there, lighting in this thing.
So but is it?
They're all minor
it's a change
changes. Yeah, and you can see there's a you know, I don't know, a couple of dozen of them there.
But these are all changes that you feel perfectly comfortable with.
Yeah, it's actually things that you know, we discuss, and he brings it back and says, well, maybe we want to think about this, or maybe we can do that, because there's other wish list items that we weren't able to do. And as we adjust some of these things, as the truck goes through production, and if there's changes on what their costs are, they reflect back to us, and it may give us to the point where we can say, all right, you know, there's a $1,200 savings if we don't do this. We want to slide out two boards, or we want to slide out a tray to put the rescue tool on. Mm-hmm. So we're constantly going to make some of these adjustments to the detail.
Okay,
awesome.
Your
motion?
Please.
Can you say the company again?
Toyne.
Toyne. Motion to accept contract change order form number one from Toyne for the town of Rollinsford for a net surplus of $278.
I will second that. Any further comments or questions? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Customer rep, that's us.
And let's see, we're beginning of August, and the truck is probably getting to the halfway point of being completed.
Awesome.
So, they're still on the December delivery date.
Do you know when in December? Have you
Late
been
able? December.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's a Christmas break.
So Late. The reason I'm asking is if it's late December, then we probably won't be, just trying to think, we probably won't be doing the dismantling of the other one until like maybe early January.
Probably.
So then we won't get that $100,000 revenue until 2018, which is not a, I'm not complaining right now, just trying to figure it out.
Speak it out loud, yeah,
yeah.
No, that's fine.
Okay.
Because some of the issues that will make that going from deservicing engine 3 now to putting the new one in service is some of that ties in is, you know, the issue we had with the funding for the rate. Because trying to do some digging and some manipulate and try to get that taken care of, but it's just not going to go where we want. So probably what we're going to end up doing is, you know, that $5,000 we kind of banked that just kind of floated away. We have to take it out of the engine now and put it into the new one. So at least it'll be serviceable, we'll have some communications and radio, but then we're going to have to budget time.
The old equipment.
The old equipment that's there now will have to be put into that, because my original thought was we were gonna take the radio out of the old engine and put it in the command vehicle. Well, I can't. So we're kinda.
Yeah, juggling. So as we get closer to, Mark, you know, we'll take a look at what the conditions were from the state, you know, for the $100,000, so that we know what the timeline is. I can't remember. I know that there was a certain length of time we had. So we'll just need to be.
Well, there's a couple of pieces to the pie also, is you're probably not aware, I'm not sure if it's really out there yet, but I am able to discuss it, is through our community mutual aid agreement with our other 10 communities, we put in, we've written, as all the fire departments together, wrote a grant, because they have an air service vehicle that Summersworth houses, so that we get an incident, it comes to fill up air bottles and whatnot. Well, thing's old and tired.
Yeah, you've
said
that.
And we wrote a grant, and we were awarded the grant. $200,000.
So that the cooperative or the consortium or whatever.
Correct. Which is, you know, we're right in the middle of that. $227,000 to replace the vehicle. So what it's gonna become is, it's still gonna have the air service vehicle, but it's also gonna be a rehab vehicle, so that if it's, you know, February and it's 10 below and the guys need a place just to get out of the weather for a little bit before they go through another evolution in a fire scenario, they'll have a place to do that. And it's gonna be, I don't wanna call it a bus, but it's gonna be a longer service vehicle.
Mm-hmm.
So that's, there's been some meetings going on, there'll be a couple more to finalize how that's all gonna work out.
Congratulations, that's a wonderful
that
thing.
Great. Well, you mean the town gets a part of it too, so it's
so
kind of.
So we're not actually, though, we're not seeing any of that money, correct? We're just.
I'm not seeing the money, but we're gonna see the use of it.
Yeah, the benefit, exactly.
For,
but from a budgetary, financial management.
It's all gonna be channeled through Barrington.
Barrington, okay.
Chief Rick Walker of Barrington Fire is the one that oversees the community mutual aid group right now.
Okay.
So his town is willing to accept an MOU and all that to do that.
Yeah.
Summersworth was backing it up. And if those two towns hadn't done it, I may have been in here asking whether or not we wanted to be the town that would accept that. But the other two have stepped up to do it. But it is, you know, again, it's a conglomerate of the 10 communities. Dover doesn't really use it because they use Lee, because Lee has a different trailer. But all the other communities around here, whether it be Southborough, Northborough, Elliott, Summersworth, Rochester, we're all going to be using this.
Well, it's great news, because I know you've said how old that.
Very undependable.
Is, you know.
Even when we could get air bottles filled, we like them on our back at 34,000 PSI. They were lucky they get to three. So the bottle has only got 3/4 of its service life, so it just kind of slows down the ability for guys to do a long duration.
Oh, yeah.
So now with the new equipment, and when that gets in, you know, the way it's going, looking at it, it's going to be in service early next year. So typically, I don't like to use the term, but everybody does, that's our fire season. It would come in kind of in the middle of that, because, you know, that's when we start getting fires.
When?
Fire season. Winter. There's a definite, you can watch the curve line go,
really?
Like that. People close up the wood stoves. Heating is now turned on all the time. Pellet stoves. The people with the alternative methods. There's a lot more fire in the winter than there is any other time. So that's when that's supposed to come.
All right. Well, that's good. Nice.
Yes, that's a very good positive for all of us in the community. The next thing is the command vehicle. And Mr. Dion, I see you're sitting there, and you had asked about in a budget committee meeting,
yes,
we had used state bid. There's the state bid. There's the forms right there. This is last year's numbers. We don't have anything for this year yet, and this is what we based getting our vehicle on. And this list, basically, have you ever looked at what a state bid list is?
No.
It just lists which
vendor
dealerships are willing to participate, and it gives you a little framework as to where the pricing is going to be. And the closest one to us is Hilltop Chevy.
Mm-hmm.
Next closest one is Vermont. And I could go to Vermont, and their price is about $1,800 cheaper. But I'm not going to go chasing something in Vermont for that, because it probably would cost more by the time we get back. So, kind of using last year's numbers, and I kind of already had a discussion with you when we were waiting a little bit.
With the board.
Yes, with the whole board. Kind of brought it up the other time, is if we had done this sooner, we would have had one for 31.9, but we kind of waited. By the way, the board had that's due. And these are 2017 prices, so the 2018 vehicle, we can't get a 2017. We have to get a 2018. And with that, a car, of course, is that bump. So I brought PO today, as I actually have. We talked with Ron Currier, who was the truck manager up there. I told him they've already ordered it. It's supposed to arrive mid next month. And that's what we're getting right now. That's our view. It's not going to be red. It's going to be white. White's cheaper.
Seriously?
Yes.
You don't get pulled over at that. That's right.
Yes.
Okay.
So that's what we're looking at. That's the vehicle right there. It has a price.
Yeah, 33,269.
Yep. And that's what my purchase order is for.
Okay. Well, let's move it and then we'll ask some other questions.
Yeah.
Move to accept purchase order 1253 to Hilltop Chevy for 2008 Chevy Tahoe for command vehicle for the amount of $33,269.
I'll say it. So, Chief, there were things that when you first came in here and talked to us about this, there were other things that you needed to do with this, right? So are you going to be able to stay within the $40,000 with those other things? To what extent are you not going to be able to stay within the $40,000?
$1,700. That's my other pile of paperwork that I have right here. Because we've done, basically, that's the vehicle. We get the vehicle for that price. The vehicle needs to be, radio communications equipment needs to be installed. Lighting package has to be installed. And a lettering designator package has to be done.
Yep.
So, two-way, this is their proposal here. We've been talking with them. We're going to probably branch out and see somebody else. Their price to do the whole thing is like $8,100. So
to do all the things you just mentioned.
Yep. Yep, correct. Just the radio itself. That's the one price for the radio. Same thing we do with anyone. It's $3,500 just for the radio. That's why I was kind of thinking, well, if I steal the one out of engine 3 and put it in there, I could get a lot done because it would be fine for what we need. But that's not going to, obviously, that's not an option at this point. So this is for the lighting package, the radio package, and the striking package. Like I said, it was like $8,100. So if we add the two together, it comes to like $41,700.
So is the $1,700 in your budget somewhere else that you can?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, it is. I'm not coming and asking for anything. No. Perfect. It just means I'm going to dig a little to get that. And my thought is I have a couple different ways I can go. I can use some of them.
And we can't ask him this year.
Well, you asked before about some of the other stuff.
Yeah.
And I was like reluctant just because I know what we're facing to get all this equipment.
Have to ask though, right?
I perfectly understand.
Yeah.
Perfectly understand. And if I had it, I've done it in the past, it would be all set, would be an issue. But I knew I had to dig for these other items. So my thought is I have a couple places I can do it. But since we're getting into August, the vehicle ain't going to be until September. My thought initially was just take it out of vehicle repair line. There's still like $6,000 sitting in there. And since if engine 3 has anything major go wrong with it, it doesn't make any sense to put the money into it. To the point where it's only going to be around for another 2 or 3 months anyway. Mm-hmm. So we would just kind of have to see what we need to do if that happens. We've been using the truck, everything's been fine. I don't anticipate nothing, but I mean, you can't.
You never know, you just never know.
You just don't know. You know, that's the roulette thing that you want to have a discussion on at one point.
Yeah.
So that's where I'm thinking of going with that. And if I took it out of that line and something happened, well, we can drag something else. There's some things in there we can do. So it's a matter of, well, I can take it out of radios. I could not buy a hose this year and use a hose the funding. There's a lot of different places to go.
Okay. As long as you feel confident that.
My initial thought is to go there. I just wanted you to be aware that's my initial thought on where I want to go. And if something else came up and we needed to have a repair and it had to get done, well, I'm not going to spend all my lines like I typically don't until I get near the end. So if that means I don't buy hose and needed $3,000 or something else, well, then that's what we'll do.
Okay.
Typically, we'll just hold off a little longer. Even the gear stuff, looking at our gear line, we don't have a lot for replacement, so there may be something there.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, I'll know better in a couple of months when we get to that.
Mm-hmm.
But making the whole thing work together, there will be money within the budget to get this taken care of.
All right, I think I'm ready to call the question.
Sure.
All right, we're voting on the purchase order for the command vehicle for $32,269. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Do you have a purchase order for the other, or are you still going to look some more? Okay, I'll let you do that then.
Still beating them up. Well, I mean, it's, they know they're going to get the engine. And they know that this is coming out of our own site. There's got to be some way to help us out with something here, because we're going to be throwing a lot of money at you, so.
All right, I'll let you continue to soften them up.
The other thing is, it's one of their members, it's one of their higher ranking officials within two ways, a member of the community mutual aid. So not only he beat them up, I can hear the other fire system.
You take yours back, right?
I take back, I don't know, I think it's the yellow one, she's the white one, she gives me back, I don't know. She'll give it to me.
Oh, who doesn't take it?
They'll find its way.
Is it fine? Please take it.
I do get one.
Please take it, I think.
No, it goes to Caroline, she does what she does, and then she gives it back to me.
Please take care of it.
Yeah, it'll find its way back. Like I said, that was the proposal for all of the other stuff, so we're still working on it. Because the thing is with the vehicle, is it's not going to have a light bar or anything like that on it. It's going to be, you know, just front-facing stuff, like you put up on your visors and front lights, back lights. So that's all we want. Doesn't have to be anything super crazy. Not for our needs.
Okay. Anything else?
I think that's all that I have for you this evening. Just vehicle stuff, updating all that, because it's summer, we tend to be a little slower, let things play out during summer time, so that's where we're at.
All right, sounds good. Anything you have?
Anything for me?
Did you get the my email on the purchase order? We only need to see things that are over $200.
Yeah, I understand that. Well, we made it 200, and, so everything really would be 199.
Over 200. Over 200.
Yeah.
So if you, it's just to make it consistent with the credit card policy.
Yeah.
I mean, at some point, we'd like to increase that more with a limited purchase order where you and Caroline can a department signature in Caroline's. But we're not there yet because we don't have the reporting on you yet. So this at least gets us consistent with the credit card is. So I don't think it's going to be a huge thing, but. Huge savings for you or us, but just to be consistent.
Yeah, consistent. Yeah.
All right.
Yep, we're all set.
All right, thank you so much.
Okay.
Have a nice evening.
Thank you.
Hello, Mr. Kawat.
Mr. Kawat, did you want to talk to us?
Yeah, I'm not on the schedule.
That's all right, come on up.
Okay. No problems, I'm going to create.
Do you have presents for us?
No, I'm here actually to commend one of the town employees. It'll take a few minutes. A couple of weeks ago, I was at the dump, the transfer station.
Yes,
in Johnson's Jump, whatever.
We know.
And the attendant there says, Joe, I got a couple of flags there. You want to take them? I said, well, yeah, sure. It was Saturday morning. I said, not right now. I'll stop in Monday. You heard the story? Maybe you haven't.
No.
It's worked pretty quick. So Tuesday, Monday I picked it up downstairs. I picked it up, brought my dump down to the shack. We got the two flags, about three by five flags. And he tells me, he says, you know, they're not small flags. They're like 3x5s you buy at Walmart. And we just said a few words together. So it's mad at these people today. So the young generation, you know, the flag don't mean anything to them. But he thought enough that he said, I didn't think they should belong in the dump. Because you guys do something with them. So I took them. Tuesday night, we had a meeting of the Ways and Means Committee. And so I brought it up to them. And we get a skeleton crew like everybody else does. The Ways and Means runs the region in July and August. And because we have to run on a monthly basis. And I brought it up. So the next morning, so they said, well, let's give them a certificate. What about post-meetings when we start again? Yeah, that sounds good. So Tuesday morning, Wednesday morning, I get an email from Ron Chabot. He's our chaplain. Flags come under the chaplain's control. And it's a copy of an email he sends to Mr. Freeman Ling, the commander. And he's dictating to him, he says, why don't you go to
buy a container for the flag. He went Home Depot, bought a big container. And then he emails him a couple flyers here that we could paste on the, you know, put your flag here and all that stuff. And so I said, well, I'll take it over to Staples. This is where he sent me. And how long with that, that does it have a long lifespan on top of the hill at the dump? So I went to Staples, and I said, yeah, we could blow that up 18 to 24. It didn't cost me 12, 13 bucks or whatever. And she said, you know, I'm explaining what we're going to do with it. She said, well, put some grommets on it. So this is what it is, we laminated. The grommets and lamination, this is it right here. So that sounded pretty good. And then yesterday morning, this is my wife.
Yes.
Shep is bringing me a load of wood at 9 o'clock in the morning. I'm getting ready to go to church. He's delivering wood. And I says, you know, we're going to do something with the town. We don't own the dump. We don't own the transfer station. I think the town's going to give us permission to get in there. So I thought I'm going to go across the street tomorrow night and see if we can get permission to the Board of Selectwomen. So I said, yeah, that makes a lot of sense. So that's what I'm here tonight. I was kind of embarrassed because the attendant is a man I should know because I see him every week.
Well,
so I waited till I came downstairs and I asked the young man that was down there, what's his name? I says, well, it's Armitage. I said, well, Joe, he's a member of the Post and everything else. And then Shabbat went to school with him. And he's already talked to him. He says, you know, we're going, what you did with, you give those flags to Joe, that's something we stand for, you know, kind of proud of that. I guess he's agreeing to the fact that maybe he will accept a certificate from us. But Ron also in his letter, give you a copy of what he sent me here. Well, maybe I won't because I don't have it. I guess I don't. It's on the kitchen table. Anyway, he said maybe we can have a copy taken and bring your camera with a picture taken. Well, if you know Joe Turgeon, he's the...
Armand.
Armand, yeah, but he goes by the name of Joe. And,
he does?
I always call him Turgeon.
Well, when he was a kid, he was Joe. Joe the National Guard. He was a Marine. Mm-hmm. Guadalcanal. And you know, the Marines didn't have a picnic at Guadalcanal.
Well,
and they don't talk about it. And he's not a blowhard. So I was concerned about that. And I've been involved quite a bit nationally with people that have done acts of valor. And you don't bring it up. Some of them, you don't know what gets into their minds. I've tried to study that. But maybe it's taking a life of someone else. Maybe it's the life of someone that was in the dugout with you in the foxhole. But they don't talk about it. We have people down at the Ronald here, two or three of them. Yeah, well, we never bring it up. We understand that. And so we, but I, he said, take a picture and put it in the New Hampshire Legionnaire. Well, that's another one of my hobbies. I'm the editor of the New Hampshire Legionnaire. And last issue that we had, I had volunteered in there quite a bit. There are 104 Legion posts in the state. I know that the other 103 out there are calling me all kinds of names. I'm the editor. I decide what goes into the paper. And I had quite a few things in there. One was our flag destruction disposal we gave the school. Because we had a couple of real close-up shots, you know, Larry Larkin and Ken Shorey and some of them. And I put them in the paper. I'm the editor. I can do it. They can fire me if they want. But no one's going to take this over. It's costly. It's a headache. And then I had another one. It was the 50th, almost to the day, the 50th anniversary of the anniversary of Joe Robinson's death in Vietnam. I knew Sergeant Joe Robinson. He was a Marine, he was a recruiter. And I was a jarhead. He used to come to the post office and shoot the breeze with me. And I remember when his body came back. Matter of fact, I was part of the color guard that received his body at Tasker's funeral home. Tasker buried him. I think it was Tasker. And it was in a pretty sight. They didn't transport bodies like that. The Vietnam War, they did. They started to transport them by flight. They would wax them and everything else, you know, everything's pushed down. But Judy, I mean, she's the best mom I've ever known in my life, and he was exposed. But almost 50 years ago, his son, Bill, also became a Marine. he blew taps for him. And we had our ceremonies at Newtown Cemetery this week buried. We have a lot of history in this town that's unknown to the population.
And you know a lot of it, Joe. You know a lot of it.
Yeah, and you know, it's right in Newtown Cemetery, and we had a big crowd there because we had concluded our church services across the street over here in the Gold Star Park, and we went to Civil War Monument, so we just all walked across from the Civil War Monument, and we had about 100 people there. And Billy plays the bugle. He doesn't play the musical instrument that all the military bases provide you now. He plays the bugle himself because he's blown it quite often for us at funerals. And it took a lot of courage for him. So we had his picture in there too in the paper. And it's in here, you know. So I'm here asking you if we can do this, if we can purchase that and put it up there.
So you would like to put a flag disposal sign at the transfer station so that folks who have flags that they don't want to use anymore.
Right now they're being thrown in my garage.
Do you know if the transfer station staff have a place where they can put them? Have they scoped that out? So we'd have to check with them to see what the appropriate spot might be then.
Yeah, who knows?
Well, we'd have to check with the staff to figure out. Do you know where?
Oh, yeah.
Well, do you want us to take it and work with them then to put that up? And well, do we have a container? Is there some?
The container is in Mr. Lane's back seat, I think. Last time I saw it, it's a great, it's a huge container.
Okay.
So this will fit real well on it. And there's another small placard that explains what you do with the flag. You know, we could probably post that above it somewhere.
All right.
And
well, we'd be happy to help take care of that. It may take a week or so before we get that in place and everything, but
I told Freeman to meet him at noontime on Wednesday, so I guess I'll give him another call.
Yeah, let us, because we'll have to figure out where we want it. Are you saying that you would help put it up? You'll bring this?
Yeah, we want to bring it up and donate it to the town.
Well, that's wonderful. So let's we'll talk to the transfer staff.
Well, we can appoint him to talk to the transfer staff.
It's one of the Legion programs. Wherever there's a Legion team, there's 114 posts in the state, a lot of them are paper posts, more or less.
Because it's a specific barrel.
They have them in some post offices outside.
Yeah.
I bet they used to.
Okay.
It's,
so my esteemed colleague tells me that, you know, we could just empower you. If you don't mind, you can talk to the transfer station staff when you go up and say you've talked to us. And
yeah, all right.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm fine with that.
Okay, we're fine with
that. I'll be up there probably about 11:30. I'll tell him when I'll take a picture. And I'll talk to Joe. I know who he is.
Armand. I only know him as Armand. You're confusing me.
And Russ is the other gentleman. And the new gentleman is...
I don't know his first name. I said Paul.
Paul.
Thank you.
Paul,
this
is
the guy's
Paul. Paul Eames is the...
Paul is transfer. Wayne is highway.
Okay.
The one that's always upstairs.
Armand.
That's Armand.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, his name's Armand.
I call him Mr. Churchill.
American Legion is Armand.
I call him.
Shatter calls him Joe.
I call him Armand.
Armand.
Yeah.
To the Jean.
Like I call you Joseph.
Wow.
Joe, thank you for all okay, you.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you so
that.
Much. We appreciate
well,
it.
You know what's happening? I'm getting older in age, and I get flags. You wouldn't believe the flags I get in my garage. And I see people in the street, Walmart, at the church. And they say, I get this flag, what are you going to do? They throw it in my garage. And they do. A lot of them.
Mm-hmm.
And if I'm not around, what's going to happen to those flags? So let's groom the town to take it over. Or the Legion to take it over.
Thank you for that.
You know, like the Legion takes care of the flag across the street over here, too, because that's originally a war memorial before we had post office there.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you so much. Have a nice evening, Joe.
Thank you, lady.
Thank you, Joe.
Yep, take care.
See ya.
See ya.
Okay. So, Jody, let's see if we can march through the rest of this agenda.
Okay.
Septic plan review. Tom does have some additional things. He'd like to talk to the board about why he still thinks he should do reviews of the septic plans.
Okay.
So we'll do something in September.
Okay.
And you're not going to be here next week, you know. I'm going to be so preoccupied with my family reunion, so I thought maybe it's a good idea to wait till the beginning of September. We can schedule something. So, all right. Third Street. This is the, what Mike brought to our attention last week about a duplex that had been renovated and didn't have an occupancy permit. So we mentioned it to Tom, and he says, yeah.
Where are you?
Yeah.
It's not on the agenda.
Well, that's not new. Huh, it's right under septic plan. Third Street.
Okay.
Maybe I added it today before Caroline printed it.
You're good.
Mm-hmm. At home. I don't know.
All right. I do have an occupancy permit in here though.
Is it okay? So Tom said that yes, he thinks that they did have a building permit, but the occupancy permit may not have done that. So is it just yours?
What street number?
Third Street. It's the Poirier duplex. I don't really know the number, but if this is the place, we will be able to get a number.
Is it third?
Or,
I think it's
this is fourth. It's third, right near the garden.
This is a Wilmer Street one.
You know, the duplex that's right at the top of the garden walkway?
Oh, yeah.
So it's definitely Third Street. Okay, so he did say he'd get an occupancy permit for that. All right, we've talked to fire. I don't think you've had your meeting yet on the transfer station damage, so we can just continue to table that.
Oh, yes, a meeting with Joe from Madbury on Wednesday night, I believe.
Oh, this Wednesday?
Yep, 5 o'clock Wednesday night.
Is this just you? It's not a cooperative or consortium meeting?
I'm not quite sure. He called me over the weekend and said, could you meet this week?
Who's
so
Joe again?
Joe is the Madbury selectman. He's also
Jay.
Thank you. Jay.
Okay. It's all right.
He's also the
his name is Joe. I think it's Joseph Moriarty, but I think he's yeah.
So
all those things.
He reached out to me, and that was the only time I could this week. So I called Northwood to see
that was our
if he got
friend
the call,
who came.
And he did not, so he's coming as well.
Oh, good. All right.
So, in good. Case there are any issues, because
yeah.
It should not be a one-on-one.
All right.
I don't feel.
I think that's a good idea. All right. Let's see. We'll go on to police removal of shed. Where are we with that?
I did not get anything back. He called sometime last week, and one of his guys wanted to get in and see the shed. And so police had to go in and lock it up. And that was the last I heard from them. Mm. But it was supposed to be turned in today, and there's nothing in the folder.
Okay. We don't have a contract either. We didn't
no.
write anything up, so.
No, but I haven't gotten a phone call. He has my
okay.
phone number. He has my email. I haven't gotten anything back yet.
Okay. All right. Well, we will continue to talk about that and see. You know, at some point we'll have to write if he decides he wants it, we'll need some little contract for the municipal association. All right. Town administration. All right, Jody, we need to talk about whether or not we're going to accept the highway block grant funds of $49,829.42.
So moved.
I'll second that. Any discussions or comments? Is there any reason why a town would not accept these, do you think? All right, then I'll call the question. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. And right now we have no plans, and so they will likely be move forward to next year, unless, you know, when Michael gets back and you all look at that, if there's more definition on the equipment, whether or not we can spend it.
At this point, I think it's probably just going to be rolled over and
yeah.
we're going to have to
okay.
figure out something else with the model.
Okay. Alrighty then, let us move on. Project updates culverts. So change order number 2. Should be in one of those folders. So we've gotten the permit from the U.S. Army Corps of Engineer, which is allowing us to put Pine Street back in the contract. That looks right. Should be signed by Boyle Tanner. Yes, it is. Okay. So I will entertain a motion to accept this change order. All that it does is to bring the contract price back to its original with Pine Street back in there, and I'll let you say the number. So it is currently this, we're increasing it to this, this is Pine Street for the total of this, which was the same as the original. So go for it.
Okay, after I say all this, I'll give it to you, Selma, so we can get the numbers. So, move to accept, make a motion to accept the change order number 2 for the culvert work. Contract price at the moment is $187,872. We're going to increase it back because we're adding Willis Street to
Pine Street,
sorry, done that twice. $91,231 for a bringing the total back up to $279,103.
I second. Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. We all sign it or just, yeah,
just
it is,
you.
Just me. Order.
You say alone.
That's right.
I'll give the numbers on there.
I'm going to take that back with me. I hate to do it, but I'm going to scan it and send it off to them tomorrow. Caroline's off tomorrow.
Yep.
Okay. I believe I sent the board the financial report that I'm sending to the USDA. Were there any questions on that, Jody?
No.
Okay, this is through July 31st. Construction oversight replacement. We heard from Hoyle Tanner that, and they're going to submit a task order for the 2 weeks that Jeff is on vacation, and it will cost us $8,000. So now we've got.
Now we're going to have to do continuing on.
Yeah, if they can find someone.
Because they're not, we're not going to be ready to have anybody oversee. Right.
And it has to be accepted by USDA. So I'll get in touch with Will Tanner ASAP.
Okay.
At the moment, you know, we still have money in the contingency, even after the $8,000 for the 2 weeks. But it could really blow it all, unfortunately. It's really expensive. Unless Will Tanner can give some other mechanism. But I will chat with them.
If we accept the new grant money, it's being used for culverts, technically.
Yeah, we could do that.
Unfortunately, I don't want it to be used for snapping, but
we could do that.
Snapping of watching a culvert being fixed.
Yeah.
So what
we would do though is continue to use the culvert project money as long as we could.
Right.
That's a good point. Thank you. I'm going to breathe a little easier tonight.
Okay.
Seriously.
You only need one glass.
Seriously.
Yeah.
All right. Good point. All right. I will let them know. This number 4 is really just there so we don't forget this after construction is completed. The Army Corps of Engineers wants a compliance certification signed after the construction. Do you not have that either?
We have it, but it's not number 4. It's number 3.
3C.
Change order number 2
mm-hmm.
is number 1. Well, number 1 is change order number 2. Number 2 is the financial report through July 31st.
Oh, yes.
Caroline must have printed these early.
Two.
Sorry. Number 3 is construction oversight replacement. Number 4 is the Army Corps of Engineer.
Okay.
Let's see if there are other surprises. All right, revaluation update. Do you have that? No, you don't.
No,
you do not. So I spoke with Chad Roberge today with regard to, Woods Run mm-hmm. and other kinds of things. And he said that, the best approach, because I said, well, is it worthwhile to have a little public session just on Woods Run or something? He said, well, the best approach is really to let people come forward who want to chat, and then we can touch base when that's over. Right now he's got 2 full days, and he had a lot of slots open when I spoke to him today. So what the gentleman who was here, Mr. Herring, does have an appointment. So we'll see what happens.
Okay.
You know, like he said, like Chad said, you know, your whole valuation is going up 20%. So sometimes when they see that 50% increase, it's not really 50% because the whole town has gone up, so it's, you know, it's still 50%. It's still,
so single family.
It's dramatic.
Yeah.
But the tax rate's going down, so it's just a question of it's hard to, for people to do their estimates, because we can't say exactly what that will look like, but. So anyway, that was the update that you provided.
Okay.
So I'm providing it to the board. Town hall drainage, we received closeout documents from our engineer, Steve Height, from Civil Works. I thought he did a good job. Did you have any questions on this?
Next time we hire them, tell them we want an estimate for the right way to do it, not just what our budget recommends.
I'm sorry, I didn't quite get that.
When we were concerned about the change order that we were gonna have to do, and I asked him why wasn't this proposed first, because it is the best way, the cement slab with the, he said, your budget, I was working within your budget of engineering.
I see, huh?
And I
said,
he said it to me on the phone personally, when we all had called him individually.
Oh, yes, okay.
So I said, I hired you to give me the best and correct answer, not what fits into my budget. So, next time we have to hire an engineer, tell them we want it done right, and not just what fits in the budget, or else we'll end up with this again.
Good point. You did have an $80,000 budget, though. I mean, that's why I'm a little...
Yeah, so...
You had $80,000, so there was enough there to manage it all, but whatever.
So, that's what he told
me,
so...
Good point, okay.
For future reference, when we hire somebody...
Good point. So, but what, with regard to the closeout document, did you have any comments? Okay.
No, looks great.
All right. Yeah, I thought he did.
Hope it works.
So, MS 535 review, I'm awaiting word from the DRA. This is Tom, this is our auditor's report that he supposedly uploaded to the DRA, because we got a message saying it was there. And we need to print it off, sign it, and then re-upload the signed comment. Well, I don't see it on the site, so I sent a letter to DRA and said, I don't see it. So, well, we will have to review it at some point. All right, CIP, Mike's not here to speak to that. Old Mill Lane Bridge, that's just there, so we don't forget, we have to get back to the state. Transfer station, Caroline sent us an email about somebody who was looking for a day pass. And my question was, what do we normally charge? And the answer was $10. And so, do we have any concerns about, it was emailed on the 2nd of August. I can see who finds it first. It was from Caroline. She forwarded it to us.
Day pass, transfer. Yeah. Yes.
I don't know what the, does it say what the property is that's being emptied out? Silver Street, 507 Silver Street.
This resident lives at that house? He doesn't live there. He's cleaning out an apartment.
Yeah. He's requesting a day pass to clean out that apartment and bring the stuff to it.
So he's not the resident of that address?
Right, I think the resident of that address is no longer there.
That's what I mean. So all rentals have to have dumpsters. So he rents a dumpster for the day and puts it in the dumpster.
What?
Okay, so you have an apartment complex. They have to have a dumpster, correct?
No, there's nothing anywhere that says they need to have a dumpster. It's in the housing standards that we haven't passed. It's nowhere else. Conventionally, I know that the front office talks about four units, but it's just nowhere written. And I don't know if this is four units on Silver Street.
Well, it doesn't matter. I'm just thinking he's not the resident there. So what's the difference between him and, I need to bring up Mr. Baldick again, Mr. Baldick, I would call it, throwing it under the bus.
He wasn't asking for a day pass.
He didn't want a day pass, correct.
He wanted one for the
whole
year.
But this one day pass is going to fill up two of our dumpsters. And same thing with the gentleman over on Oak Street, too. So, for $10, they're getting rid of $600 worth of stuff.
Well, are you surmising that, or do you know that for a fact?
I'm surmising.
Okay, so we really don't know what he's going to bring.
Okay.
But you know, your point is that this could be a losing proposition for the town. I mean, I think that's really what you're saying.
Yes.
Yeah. So what we should do, I think, is revisit what these day passes should cost.
And then the monitoring of them dumping at the transfer station, if he is using a truck, it's supposed to be so much for truckloads.
If he has disposal stuff, though, I mean, there's still, this is just the pass. He still has to follow the disposal fees, right?
Correct.
So whatever they are, I mean, if you've got a, I think there is something for a truckload.
It is.
Yeah, so he's gonna follow that. This is just gets him into the door. Does that make a difference in your calculus?
No, that's okay.
Do you want us to?
If I have no legal other course, then so be it, but then, yeah.
Do you want us to put it on the agenda?
No, he has to get it done and.
But I mean, for future, you know, should we think about a day pass that's more or? So, yes, for day pass. Okay. But they still also have to pay for the disposal of everything.
Right. So, and as you know, it's more convenient to just put it in a dumpster in your yard. But obviously, it's more cost effective to drive it to your transfer station.
Right, but if you think of it, all those whatever he's bringing.
Mm-hmm.
So if that resident had a pass,
mm-hmm.
for that resident paid $10 for,
mm-hmm.
that stuff would be going, and it would be the same. Whether the town makes out or not, I don't think we'll.
Right, but it does cover our costs, is what I'm.
It should cover. I mean,
yeah,
the
really
fees.
Doesn't.
The then right. We need to look at our fees.
Right.
Which we did, you know, it's been a couple of years since we've looked at them.
Just my two thoughts.
Yeah, no, it's good. I love just know. Oh, we had that. Come on, machine. Junkyard permit. So, when I checked in with Caroline today, the DES had not heard from Casinelli, is that his name?
Mm-hmm.
Casinelli. So he is not.
Yeah, that's in the folder too.
Yes, and so our building inspector or code enforcement officer, you know, it's the same person, his recommendation is that we not grant the license until we hear from DES.
So we send him a letter?
Yes, we should.
Okay. He also sends it late.
Yeah, you said that. He did that last year too.
Yes,
as
he
you
did.
Pointed out.
Because it ended June 30th. And this is dated July 31st.
All right, REC Committee, anything you'd like to say about the REC Committee?
They're doing great. They're almost done. Apparently they're doing 3 field trips on the last week. I won't be here for them. They went to the Fort Worth house today. My daughter had a great time.
They took 20 kids over there.
They had 20?
Yeah. So. Nice. Okay, excellent. I was by there today because I was looking at the culvert stuff, and it must have been lunchtime because there's just a few kids out on the playground.
Yes.
They eat inside.
They eat behind the trees or inside or, yeah. Yeah, I was there around 10:30, 11 o'clock, and they were all going to grab snack and lunch or whatever. But right before that, they were having dodgeball and capture the flag and something else.
Yeah. Excellent. All right, utility assessment method. I did finally read that, the letter that we got from Avatar, and I sent it. I had some questions, so Carolyn's going to arrange for a chat to either speak to the board or to answer our questions by email. And I don't remember what they were, but I sent them off. So we'll just put this there until we can get the questions answered. 2020 census, there's something in the folder. I don't know exactly what it is.
What was supposed to survey that
we're
supposed to fill out.
Oh, we're supposed to fill it out? Is that what it is?
It looks like it. I took a quick peek at it.
Oh, so it's an update. Shall we ask Caroline to take a peek at this? All right. I can help her. A lot of us can help her.
Is there an Salma's desk? Caroline is visible.
Historical committee, Mike is not here. Joint loss, you have something to talk about?
Yes, I sent you the minutes and you ruined my surprise. Joint loss was wondering why we have not gotten on the ball with our job descriptions. Mr. Fogarty was like, well, why haven't that been done?
People have a hard time putting their hands around what part-time really means, you know? But nonetheless,
they recommend that the board pursue this because we recommend it to
It is a good thing to do.
So
undoubtedly,
they are asking Caroline and Kate and not Kate, Andrea, ask Kate. She's not compelled to do it, but ask her if she would make up a job description for future.
We have some, you know, here and there.
That. And the chief will take just their duties, and Richard, their duties, and then chief was going to take command of that and try to work up a job description out of that to present to you.
Perfect. So there are some. I know that Andrea worked at a tax collector one.
Ooh.
So I told Caroline that, you know, I can scour my email and this and that and find these things and stick them in that folder.
Yeah, Caroline didn't say anything about that.
So it's later on today.
Yeah, but she didn't say anything at the meeting that they were, that Andrea had already had that done.
She didn't know.
Oh, okay.
She didn't know.
Good enough. So.
I don't even remember how it came about, but I vaguely remember, and Andrea walked in at some point. I was, oh, yeah, I did do something. I remember now.
Good.
So somewhere, I think what it was, somebody must have gotten a hold of a tax collector job description. We sent it to her to review.
Mm-hmm.
She says, yeah, I think that's pretty good.
Yeah. So there's a. We asked them for a due date. I think Caroline was going to ask it, everybody. For September 18th, I believe. I sent you the minutes. And we'll review them at the next joint loss in October. And we're working on MSD. So I did this floor for MSD and did not know that the janitor's closet was in the men's room.
Can you say what an MSD is, just so?
The material safety data sheets.
Mm-hmm.
I think they dropped a letter somewhere along there. So I got to add a few more things, but this floor is done. It's in the selectman's office with MSD on the outside, dated this year. I just have to add the 5 items that he had in the closet.
How often do they need to be updated?
They're supposed to be current at all times.
Yeah. Well, how does one do that?
I've been practiced for 25 years, and no one wants this job. Because every time you buy a new product, that like the Palmolive over there, if you change to Dawn, you have to have an MSD for the Dawn. And you can keep the Palmolive in there, but whatever you have has to be in there.
I see. Wow.
So,
okay.
And then come to find out, the fire department's supposed to have a copy of all businesses in town and their MSDs.
Mm-hmm. Do they?
They have most, actually. I was really surprised. I did not know that about businesses. So,
under auspices of the EPA, is that, OSHA?
They fall under OSHA usually.
OSHA, okay.
So.
Well,
all I know is I don't like it at work, and I don't really like hearing it.
Yeah.
Busy paperwork that no one ever looks at. So when somebody gets something in their eye, you're supposed to go to the MSD and see what to do.
So everybody needs to know where these things are.
Right. And it's part of their fire drills and things like that. Do you know where the MSD book is kept? Do you know how to read it?
Is it in the men's room?
No, the janitor's closet's in the men's room. The MSD book is in the office, for this floor.
So does that mean we can only hire male janitors?
That's what I said to Caroline. So I said, well, what happens when we have a female janitor? And, or custodian, or whatever you want to call it. She goes, well, just switch to the bathroom sign. I said, good idea.
Well, I have a story about. Policies and procedures, welfare, we decided we were going to work on it, so Mike is not here.
Okay.
Scanning items, board member activities and updates.
So, rec was canceled, we didn't, couldn't find quorum. They haven't set another date yet, camp ends next week. I'm meeting with Lamprey on Wednesday. And joint loss meets again in October, October 16th. Joint loss meets at 9:00.
All right. So I have a Sea Coast Stormwater Coalition meeting on Wednesday in the afternoon. And that's the extent of my activity for this week. And let's see, so shall we go right then to building permits?
Sure.
You are in charge of all of our folders tonight.
I know.
Oh my God. Board member Lavoy Collins.
Oh, nuts over here tonight. Two septic designs. First septic design is Wentworth Street, subdivision lot 4, map 2S18-13. Doesn't have an address yet.
Okay.
So,
looks like Tom has okayed it, and you've got your stamp, so I'd say stamp away.
Yes, so, and then the other one is for 41 Rowland Road.
Mm-hmm.
Looked at that. Is that you guys? That's not you guys.
No, they're already started on it. It's across the street in the, on the...
Is this the McKittrick?
Yes.
There was some,
we did sign it last
week. It was approved once before.
To address the above defined request. So we submitted.
There was some question about, when I left, you know, Caroline was still awaiting word back from Jason Pahopic, which was the designer, so they must have got it straightened out. Tom was still here at the time, so.
Oh, something about their D-box insulation.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't below freezing level.
All right, so they got to fix
it. We should have known.
Not I.
There's no way to
not I.
design until you actually take it up. So.
It's a magic number, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Everybody has their folders. Let's see them lights.
And you'll write up the public hearing minutes. It shouldn't take you too long. Thank you.
Yeah. building permit, 2017-89, for 6878 Front Street. And reviewed by Tom, they are repairing new shingles for $16,000 for a fee of $185. Granted, expires 2017. Building permit 2017-084, 34 Wentworth Street. New construction. Rough and finished plumbing, complete HVAC systems and gas piping. $17,500 for a fee of $250. Reviewed by Tom Clark and accepted. Building permit 2017-087 for 484 Portland Ave. New construction. 484 Portland Ave. Plumbing for a single family dwelling.
Is it mortgage? Is that the place?
Yep.
It's a house. It's in construction. So oh. This is just the, this sounds like it's the plumbing piece.
Yeah. I don't think I've been by there recently.
You can't.
Plumbing for a single family for a fee of $105. The total was $7,200. Tom Clark reviewed it. Okay.
It actually is nicely pushed back so you don't see all that much of it from the road.
Oh, okay.
And they've got it so that the narrow side
Kitty Connor
is kind of faces Portland Ave.
Oh.
Transfer. Well, just the thing is this file. And I'll just put it right on it.
We just spoke about asking for his.
Yep, we're not done it just yet.
We're not acting or we're denying, you know. It's denied. Because once it lapses, it's lapsed.
We should point that out in the email, in the letter to him, that he doesn't have an active license.
Do you want me to put no action?
That's
what you did last year.
You know, he did operate for a few days last year. I mean, I think it's more of a challenge this year because now we've got some DES violations that he needs to take care of. Mm-hmm. So I think we should point that out in a letter to him.
Right.
And and say he needs to get in touch with us. I think we should give him a deadline for managing all of this.
Updated.
So what is today's date? Should we give him until the end of this month?
8. So 31 days old?
Yes.
August
31st.
Yeah. Are you going to write the letter or is she?
She's not here tomorrow. I don't know. If I have time, I'll write the letter.
Okay.
I I should pass it by Tom, because Tom is better versed in what we can say and can't say and this sort of thing. But I can draft it and show it to him.
I'll put Caroline to write the letter and to talk to Tom.
Yeah, that's good. Won't happen tomorrow, then it'll happen Wednesday. She'll be back Wednesday.
Okay. Okay. Asked Caroline to fill out the census in her free time. Occupancy permit, single family building permit 2017-019. The single family residence Schindberg Builders located at 23 Wentworth Street, Rollinsford, effected by Tom Clark on July 24th. And you already signed this.
Yeah, this. We've talked about this. We talked about it last week.
That was last week.
Letter of Mr. Meehan. Did we send them one?
Oh, this is for the
current use.
I think that our attorney included the letter from Avatar.
Okay.
But he didn't say, he didn't give a deadline date. So this gives them till September 22nd.
Yep.
So are you okay with my signing this?
Totally.
Okay.
That's all last week.
It's all running. Okay. Purchase order. Purchase order 1257 to City of Dover for the police. Vehicle maintenance line. Inspections. Inspection for Cruiser 71. Inspection for Cruiser 72, 73, and 74. Four tires for Cruiser 74. One oil change for Cruiser 74. For a total of $786.44.
Second. Any discussions? Those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those are there for you to look at.
I saw. These are legal bills.
Mm-hmm.
Let me put them earlier. Want to speak on this?
This is from the Garden Club, but it was dated in February, so I don't know if this just turned up. So we happen to have a garden club meeting this Wednesday, so I'm going to ask Robin. I said, Robin, do you want us to put this on the website?
Mm-hmm.
It's letting the town know of the initiative, you know, if they want to contribute, or if they want to say where they think they'd like a tree, or where would be a good place for a tree. Just to remind people, I mean, the four trees that were donated last year, there was a fifth one that was donated, so it's a little set behind. You've got the four closer to the road, and there's one set behind a little bit. A nice maple, I think it is.
Oh, I didn't know.
And then there are two evergreens around the corner from the garage.
Okay.
On the back. And I know that it's not quite there, but the people across the street there, Patterson, thank you. They thought that it's going to be a nice thing. So those are all part of the tree initiative.
Okay.
So, which is done by donations, and so it asks for donations, and I don't know whether it's just turned up, so I'm going to ask Robin if she's still, we'll put it on the website.
All right.
May I speak to
you? Yes, of course.
I found that, and I suggested putting in fall is a great time for planting trees.
It is a great time for planting trees.
And
it doesn't say that?
No, it doesn't.
Well, it was done in February.
I know, but for it to come out now, I think you need some.
We might. Okay. Let's find out if Robin still wants us to, with the garden club is meeting this week. So I felt bad that somehow this got lost and we didn't do it then. So.
Stratford. We're looking at offering through the Stratford County Conservation District plant sale for much cheaper alternatives. Is that at the end of the year sale when the state doesn't use it?
It's in the spring, so it's already sort of passed.
So that can't be.
Because
I know at the end of the year, whatever trees they don't use, they get rid of.
I mean, what we'd like to do is encourage people to plant trees in general. And so I think that was just saying you can get them, cheaply through the conservation district. And if you have ideas for where the town can plant trees, let us know. And if you'd like to donate to plant trees, please donate. So.
Constant quarterly on the
website. Yeah.
Or
something like that. So So I'll just bring it fall. I'll see how she wants to manage that.
Okay, sounds great. Move to accept purchase order 1256 to Townsend Energy for one service call for the HVAC for $187.
I'll second.
Don't we have them under contract? I don't know. This is dated. Was it before our service date?
No, I don't think so.
But invoice date July 20th.
It's probably just the materials, right?
Labor. Just labor. No parts, no taxes, just labor.
I don't know what the maintenance contract is supposed to cover. Do you want to hold off until we find out? Or do you want to just...
You want to sign it with a question or not?
So we didn't pay for any parts, just labor. So I don't know what the service contract. Off the top of my head. All right.
Because we have 30 days to pay it.
What does it cover, yeah?
Then Mike can sign it next week.
Sure.
Okay. And what was the number on that?
1256.
Is Caroline going to be here the rest of the week?
Wednesday and Thursday.
Okay. Happens to have her clean up the, because Mike won't know what's all to look soon. Department of Environmental Services, Shoreland Program permit application for Wentworth Road in Rollinsford. Map 2S lot 18-6. So written to RSA 541, please be advised that New Hampshire Department of Environmental Services accepted the application on August 2nd for the permit program and subject property referenced above. Technical review of the application package will be completed within 30-day time frame. So,
what is it?
The DES Shoreland Program for one of the lots on Wentworth.
Do you know why? Do you know, are they asking to do something?
Nope, they just wanted us to be aware.
So we're just an FYI on this?
Yeah. I'd have to look at the RSA.
Oh, so accepted an application.
They have 30 days to review it.
So they have, so they're going to review something, so whatever it is. Okay, so we'll see it again if there's another...
All right, Civil Works, this was last week. Civil Works is representing Mr. Phipps on his land use change.
Yeah, so Caroline is trying to get a meeting together with Avatar, Mr. Phipps, Mr. Conley, and
okay, we'll have to go into non-public for elderly review.
Okay, we can wait till the end.
Urban tree service, we already signed.
Yeah, but we're not going, we're putting this on hold. Remember, this is $10,000 for trees. And, thank you.
I'm out of postage, you can't write anything else.
So, I mean, there won't be anybody here to organize it at the moment anyway, so just so you know. It happens.
I know. All right. State of New Hampshire DOT. Here is your block grant anticipated for 2018 for a total of
$58,897. Oh, that's our
2018. Yes, this is more money.
No, we won't get that until
2018.
Just looking to see if it's an increase.
How much is it? Sorry.
I won't keep us, but it's roughly what we got, so it's no change really.
Oh darn. EverSource just letting us know what trees they're cutting. Information we were supposed to give to Beverly. Impressive results at the transfer station. These were all from last week. Change order number 2. We just signed that.
Well, I was looking for it last week. I wonder, and Caroline wasn't sure if she printed it, so it's just enough. Let's just void it. We've signed it.
Comcast, July 27th. Coming days, notify our customers of updates of Comcast agreement, residential services, as well as providing a copy of the updated agreement with their August bill. Residential services, terms and conditions for Xfinity, internet, and voice service. So,
just fine.
Letter for roofing, 10 Highland Ave.
Okay.
So moved. And the letter from the Water District Sewer is cold. Bond bank, oh, this is old. Bond bank.
We have our money.
So, yeah.
Yeah, I don't think we have anything to do, much to do with them, except yearly we have to keep certifying that we're still, you know, non-municipality and non-profit or whatever. We're not a for-profit company. That should be easy to prove.
Yes.
To
okay.
Certify.
That clears out my file.
All right. So we're good then. We'll do community input and then we'll go into non-public for an elderly exemption.
Correct.
Okay. Any community input? Yes.
When you're talking about job descriptions for joint loss, are you including like other organizations overseen by the town, like REC and all of that?
REC already has theirs.
Okay.
So they already did this.
Yeah. I just wanted to.
It's really employees. It's really for employees.
Yeah.
And, you know, and we would start with our kind of sort of regular employees, you know, and it's a bonus that the REC committee, which would sort of fall under seasonal.
Right.
Yeah. Those are Donna.
That's a wonderful thing. That's right.
Yeah, I don't think we need to change those.
Yeah.
So. We have other fish to fry.
But we have a folder to put those in. I don't know where they are, but.
They're on the drive under the REC committee.
Oh, under the REC committee, okay. Okay, that's fine. Anything else?
Has somebody from the town been going around doing reviews of culverts and drainage?
No, but somebody from the Stratford Regional Planning Commission is probably doing that.
Okay, because somebody was in my neighborhood last week looking at the drainage pipe.
So the Stratford Regional Planning Commission, you know, does regional planning and they do various inventories of infrastructure and the like, and they did a culvert inventory. I think there's still a link to it on our website that we got maybe 3 years ago, but they're doing an update this year. So I'm assuming that's what that was, because it's the town didn't ask for anything. I just know that.
Well, they came in a town truck and they said they were reviewing things.
A town truck?
Yes.
A town
of Rollinsford truck pulled up in front of my house. And two gentlemen got out and they said they'd been looking at culverts and drainage all day. And this is one of their last stops.
Or it could be the people doing the work on our culverts, the Parker and Dahl.
Parker and Dahl, why would
Because they came here when I was here for joint loss. And they used our truck to drive over here. Because they had to get something done.
But then, were they not working over there? That's odd.
I know their office. Their office is down here. So.
Have to send the truck.
Yeah, I don't know. It's a good question. I don't know the answer.
Or it could be Wayne.
Could be.
Yeah.
Wayne was doing some drain. They were cleaning out storm drains.
That's what it could have been, because this is like a storm drain that goes under the road.
All right. So Wayne was taking care of that, I think, while Jeff was over with the culvert. So that could be what was going on there.
And the building permit for Front Street, I think Mike referenced it, that work has already been done, the roofing was done on Front Street.
So we signed the building permit?
Yeah.
So, retrospect.
Yeah, at least you got a building permit, yeah.
Building permit.
Oh, that was all my input, okay.
All right, yes, Nancy?
I don't know the address right offhand, but on Clement Road, I think it was a farm at one time. It's right near the Jacobsons. They put on a new roof and new chimney. It's under Hackett.
What do you mean it's under Hackett?
That's who bought the property.
So the tax card, we have Hackett, is that what you're saying?
That's when I was going down through the Avatar listing to try to find the address there. He purchased it and he's been doing work on it.
Okay.
I hate to turn him in because he's a friend, he's a child of a friend of mine, but I said to him, I said, the dangers of putting up a chimney without it getting inspected is severe. So that's the only reason I think that Tom needs to go and make sure that...
Well, no one is above the law.
That's right, no one's above the law. All right, thank you. All right, so we ready to, anything else, Jeremy, or ready to go into non-public?
Oh, well, no, I'm just trying to clean up the public, but...
Sorry.
Motion to go into non-public for reasons of elbow.
Exemptions. All right, I'll second that and check with the roll call. Jody?
Yes.
Suzanne, yes. And I will send you the updated minutes.